Hello, it's me again.
Hello, it's me again. If you can see this thing on my lip, it's not a cold sore. It's for some reason I break out on my lip, and then in an hour or so it'll be gone. it's like some weird allergic reaction that I have. I've never had a cold sore, but cold sores don't go away in like an hour or so. It's not. My husband's always like, "Oh, you're getting a cold sore." No. Anyway. I'm COVID free. Woohoo. Woohoo. Oh. Sorry, ran my foot pedals into my desk. I was doing a celebration. Woohoo. 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 I'm crazy. Okay. So me and my weird thing on my lip are gonna do powders. So you guys can watch. It's like my favorite part. I love doing powders because it kind of like brings out, you know, they kind of start looking more like a baby and less like a doll, but still, they're very pale, so we got a ways to go. So I'll put you guys up here and can stop looking at my lip. Can stop obsessing about my lip. Me, you know. So it'll be gone by the time we end the video. Okay, so see you guys in a second. Okay, let's get the powders out. Okay, I'm gonna use my Coastal Scents. I have more blue. It's down in there. I like my blue. Let me get my. Oh, shut up. Wheelchair. And I'm still waiting on the insurance funding to come through. This is all stiff, needs to be washed. I need this. I'm just getting out some of my favorite brushes that I like to use. I got two blue brushes, one yellow brush. Let's see, where's my vein brush? There it is. Okay. I still sound sick, but I'm not. So, I'll put this behind here. Alright, so, I like to use this really dark red for, like, creases. I have this really tiny brush that I get to use, and then I rub it in with the sponge. I did a little bit of Christmas shopping this morning. I got lots more to do. My husband just loves this time of year. I sold the Benjamin, and he's going home day after tomorrow. So, here's a little bit of Christmas money. I'm going to go ahead and do these little wrinkles on her eyelid, just lightly. I'm not going to do anything under her eyelids, because I want to put some blue there. I want to go around her little nosy. The important thing is to rub it in with a sponge, because otherwise a lot of it will wash off anyway. And unless you're using pan pastels, it'll stay longer, but easier, better, stay longer. It's it's more pigmented, so. It will stay on the baby, even if you don't rub it in. Okay, here we go. Okay, I'm gonna go inside her nose, get the back. You want the nose to look like it's open without opening it. I'm going to go in the crease of the mouth. Make the mouth look like it's open. And you can do this with paint too. I just like the way it looks with the powders. I'm going to put a little bit in here. Inside the Cupid's bow. You don't want to put too much in there either. You don't want to make that too red. Brush for the ear. So basically I just go around all the creases and do all the little details. Here, I'll show you guys where I use blue. I'm going to use this lighter blue. I go under the nose. I'm going to use this side for blue and the other side for red. And all this stuff that I'm doing, oops, you guys can't even see. Here, I'm going to go out. Can't even see what I'm doing. I just go right under the nose right here. And these are all like blue undertones. And I go over this like, you guys can see that. I go over this a couple times while I'm painting, depending on the baby that I'm. I do one underneath the chin, some blue underneath the, or underneath the lip, sorry, and a little bit on the side. I gotta keep an eye on the camera, make sure you guys can see anything at all. Okay, so I put some blue over here, and I'll show you guys how I do veins before I turn this off, and I can come back and show you guys how it looks. So there's like usually little divots in the forehead and on the side of the head that I put a little bit of blue in. And when you're doing the blue, wash, you can, if you're making like a darker baby, you can do some extra blue throughout here too. I just like the way the powders look. And then, where's my little brush? That's not it. Is it? Yeah, it is. Okay. I use this this darker blue for my veins. So I just make like little marks with the like where a vein would be. And then I rub it in, so it's the same kind of thing. And you guys can see that. And again, I'll go over this if it gets too light or gets too buried underneath all the paint. Just to make sure that they have veins showing. I'm going to do some over here on the side of the head. I do some little, like, bunch of little squiggly veins on the sides of the head. But it looks way more realistic with the powders than it does with the paint. With the paint, it's still... You got to get it like really, really watery. And then, paint them on and then dab them out. Otherwise, they look fake. At least with the acrylic paints. With the oil paints, the Genesis paints, you can make them look more realistic. But like I said, that's one of the reasons I like the powders. because you can make it all feathery and nice looking underneath. So you make do with what you got, you know. I like to paint with my acrylic paints. I like them. I'm not breathing in. Like I said, I don't have to worry about toxic fumes. And I just use my powders for things like this. Okay, so I will be back and I'll show you guys the finished product. Okay, so I got all the powders done. You can see I did some blushing, some on the lips. You guys can see. You can probably see better without the light. I don't know if you guys can see all the veining that I did. Probably see better in the light. I put veins all over her head and on the sides of her head and the back because I'm going to paint like more kind of lighter hair and I want some of that to show through. So I did her ears, some blushing, you know. I did a little bit of yellow on the nose, some yellow on the cartilage of the ears. And the lips, and sure, I did the same on Martin. You can see they have the same, they have the same exact same vine also. And I'll show you another reason why I like to do the powders on like the feet and the hands is because you can get in all those little creases with the powders. Okay, I shot the first part of this video like a couple days ago because I've been busy doing other things. The part with the powders and stuff. And I got Sebby done. Yay, Sebby. The hair a little wet still. I had deep condition the hair, but Sebby's a curly head. So I'm not assigning Sebby like a gender because I can't make up my mind, so I'm going to dress them either like gender neutral or in boy clothes and girl clothes, so whoever buys Sebby can decide, or you know, just because I don't know, I think they could be either or. I see the little eyelashes I did, little blonde and red eyelashes. So there's some blonde hairs in there and some red hairs in there. I have the hair all glued in and the eyes glued in and everything. I put a little bit of Pledge even on my glass eyes because it makes them look wet and shiny. Makes them look nice. So we'll get Sebby all put together and I'll do a photo shoot and I'll finally finish the photo shoot of Ashia. And I'll put them both up for sale. And I'm still working on Madeline. I'm almost done with her too. So, and then I'm going to start either gonna root Nyla or so it's Naomi. So it's either gonna be Naomi or Nyla. So she's going to have like white hair because she's an albino. And Nyla will have black. And I'm going to start rooting my Vito. He doesn't have eyes right now because I ordered some just like the ones I got for. So I got the same eyes for Vito as I did for Zoe. So what I'm doing is I'm doing a ultramarine violet sponging layer. So I'm gonna do this on. Did I have my light on? Yeah. I don't know why it seems weird. Light's weird today. So just gonna sponge this on here because mottling is not showing through very well. So this sponging layer will kind of bring it out more. I'm stuffy today. Like I said, I am all negative and everything, but it just hangs on forever. Okay. I'm not gonna brush this off, but I am gonna show you that I'm doing like a wash on the hands and feet. I'm gonna go over the ear too. Because I want the ears and the hands and feet to have a little more color. And then I'm going to stop painting them because I don't want them to have any like darker colors on them. Like the, I'm going to do a raw sienna layer. And I may do a, this stuff. It's a, what's it called? I can't talk today. That's something new, isn't it? You know me, I'm always have this transparent red iron oxide. That's what that is. So I may use that. Make up my mind yet. Okay. I'm going to show you how I do the arms and legs. This is pretty quick. Just sponge it on. It's a kind of a pastel-y color, so it's not gonna be too dramatic. It's just gonna help bring out that mottling layer, the red mottling layer, and I may do another one, like another Alizarin Crimson Hue sponging, so it'll show up even more. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna do like a light wash on the feet and hands. And I'm just gonna brush it off with this. Sorry about my nose, I sound terrible. I should go take a cold pill. And my sense of smell and stuff is coming back, but I didn't lose my sense of taste or anything completely just because of my nose, you know, typical of like when you have an upper respiratory infection. But, sometimes I'll like smell weird thing, like it'll just, like this weird smell will get stuck in my nose. That happens a lot when I get, a sinus infection. Okay, so you see, I just did a light wash on the feet because it'll bring out the, like a, make more of like a pinky color. Okay, so I'm going to finish her up and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm going to put another coat of yellow on them. Raw sienna. There's not much difference between yellow ochre and the raw sienna. Kind of looks pretty much the same. And then I'm gonna, I think, just go ahead and do another sponging of the red. What's it called? I'm going around the ears because I don't want to get them too yellow. But I might go ahead and paint them after. Might go over a little bit. I'll just go over them. I'll go ahead and do the ears with this coat of yellow. But then the ears and the feet and everything we need to leave alone. Okay. There we go. Okay, so yeah, because they definitely need more of like a mottling layer. So I may do even like I'll do a sponging with the red, the Alizarin Crimson Hue. and we'll see how that looks. And if I'm not happy with that, then I'll make it thicker and do like an actual mottling, which I should have done in the first place. Sorry, I hear people speaking French in the background. It's my son and my aide. So, there we go. I need to do her lips and stuff too. I'm going to show you how I'm going to do the, I'm just going to go over the feet, like, in the middle here to make them, like, look and around the tops and stuff like that. But I'm not going to do the toes or the, too much on the, I'll brush it over, but I'm not going to, like, paint directly on the heels and the toes and stuff. So, yeah, that's basically how I'm doing it. Same with the hands. Because if you paint too much on the hands, they end up looking since there's, these babies have lots of little creases and crevices, you end up with dirty looking hands and feet. You don't want that. Oops. Got a little. Okay, so I'll be back. Okay, so I went ahead and did Alzer and Crimson Hue sponging. So the same thing we did with the purple, the violet, just, you know. There's still, everything's kind of muted. It's mainly because of the type of vinyl. But I'm hoping some of the mottling will show through later. But I did powders on her. That's why, you know, her knees and everything look pretty red and stuff. That'll be more muted too. I did some purples and reds on her eyelids. And I'm working on Martin's powders too. So I think I'm going to do this orange next. I usually like, I'll use my hand, the palm of my hand. Right now it's kind of red because from my fingers are. I use the palm of my hand and I use my color wheel to gauge, like, you know, how much more color we need. And like I said, it looks kind of still really pale, powdery pale. So, like cold. You can see they look cold. So I need to warm them up. So the best thing to do would use yellow, and they've already have, you know, quite some yellow. So orange would be the next best thing. So we'll come back and do orange wash probably, unless I change my mind. But more than likely we'll do that. So I'm going to finish up powder. So I do another, you know, layer of powders. And then, yeah, we'll just move on from there. So should be done soon. And then we can start on hair painting. I'm just brushing out Sebby's hair over here. So I will be right back. My eyesight is completely gone. I can't see myself at all. I hope I look okay. Okay, so again, we have little Sebby. And the hair's kind of messed up right now. But it looks much better. It's not as frizzy. And I just thought I'd stick this in here. I gave Sebby a little haircut, as you can see. Because I was just too crazy and frizzy. So this looks much better. You can if you want to, there's a little part here. You can, like, sweep it over to the side. So it looks more like a, maybe looks a little more like a boy that way. I don't know. The hair's kind of versatile, so you can do a few things with it. And it's curly, so you can fluff it, make it curly. The back looks much neater now. looks more realistic. A little baby like this would have short hair like this. And it's neater and easier to care for. So, there we go. So I'm going to put him together again this weekend. Not again. I'm going to put him together. Him, her. What Sebby looks like when it's all put together. Get you the blue sclera eyes. Oh, let's focus here. Looks more pale on the camera, but then again, I can't really tell in this tiny little viewfinder with my eyes as bad as they are right now. Because I've been staring at close-up of the baby. You can see the little swirl right here. Meow, meow. I did the pledge on the eyes. Okay, so I'm gonna put the head back down so the glue can dry. So I'll probably be back tomorrow. We'll finish up these babies. Try to space the videos out a little bit because, and it seems like if I do too many videos in a row, I don't get very many views. So, yeah. I've been around Sebby too long. So I'm going to get Madeline done next week because her hair's about to here. So I need to bring up the part and do the little, no, do the bangs. I'm going to do the bangs with some, what's it called? Mohair. Because the human hair, she just got the little, her forehead's about like this big, you know. So if I did like human hair, it would like stick up. It would, you know, it won't lay flat like the mohair is more fine, so it'll lay flatter. So I'll show you guys how she looks when I'm done with that. And you guys can help me decide who I should root next. Should I root Naomi or should I my albino? Or should I root Nala, which she's a black baby. If you guys remember, I painted her the same time as the giveaway baby, as Johanna. And your little Shia, she wanted to say goodbye. She's in her little sleeper. It's her little pink pacifier that I made for her. I think she looks cuter with the pink pacifier. Okay, so if you guys like what I'm doing, please like and subscribe. Go get a authentic doll kit and some paint. You like a Shia, an authentic doll kit, like a Shia, and some paint and eyes and hair and all the stuff you need, and make a reborn because it's fun. Okay, bye.